Right, here we are, still in digs, and it's Thursday, 3rd of September. Should be on the needles now, and actually on watch probably. But it's been five or six blowing all day. Started off at 12 o'clock, 50-50 chance of going. Back at 4 o'clock, and we could see it was far too rough. Wind was really blowing. But they hung on and hung on. And then they finally cancelled at 5. Me pleased as punch because I thought helicopter comes up from the Channel Islands and it's ready just to do us tomorrow. But they're going to give it one more try in the morning, boat relief. And the forecast is still force 5 or 6. So hopefully it won't be done in the morning and we can go on by helicopter in the afternoon. I just hope he doesn't try and attempt this relief in the morning, because it really is rough out there and I don't fancy an hour long sea trip with waves coming around.
Better for this morning though.
That got them and not me.
Suggested, but if they can't get it on the land side, if they can't come in on the inside and check it out line up. We should get over that way, over.
Yeah, all over the side.
Well, the story so far is we're on the Needles Lighthouse, as you saw. Bit of a bumpy ride out. We had to come out at 6 in the morning, thereabouts. We got on board about 7. The other lot have gone. And in the mad rush, as per usual in things like this, all our frozen meat, all the meat we're going to consume, and yogurts and stuff like that, has all been left ashore. Hasten to add, it weren't our fault, because we'd sent it off with a boatman to be frozen overnight, and he left it on the jetty somewhere. So now, Dave Highmire's just been on to the mermaid that's in the area. They've picked up the meat, and sometime today they're going to drop it off. So knives and forks and plates will have to be put away until we receive it. So, don't know when we'll get our dinner. The other thing is, it's 10 o'clock now, so we've been on board about 3 hours. And apart from sitting down for this sort of ritual drink, warm drink, most of the time has been unloading our food boxes. I'm in the bedroom at the moment. Looks like I've got the top bunk. Also looks like I'm in charge for the fortnight I'm here, because Dave doesn't want to do it. Freezers, they're up the next level. No, that's the fridges up the next level. Freezers, close to the bottom. So all this unloading your food, it's a case of pulling stuff upstairs and pulling stuff downstairs. And never the twain shall meet. It's just a case of as I've said before, trying to find spaces for everything around it and find lockers to put it all away in. So, next thing is all me clothing and personal gear. I've got to find places for that. And then, should be dinner time, but I think we'll just have to have rolls for lunch and wait till we get anything else. It's just a matter of storing everything away. And surprise, surprise, I'm on morning watch, so I'm supposed to be on watch now till 12 o'clock midday. So it'll be a quick run round to see how everything goes. So when I'm back on at 8 till midnight tonight, if fog comes in, I'll be able to handle it. Afternoon, 2:30 on the first day on board Needles Lighthouse. I'm sat here squinting because the sun is shining straight on me. I'm up in the lens. This seems to be the spot where keepers come up to read and do their diaries and stuff, so I brought mine up to write up. Story so far about our food. So far we've been on to personnel. And they've got onto the mermaid ship, which is in the area, in fact just off us at the moment. And they're going to replace all our meat because they think it's been stuck on the jetty too long without any coal. So to be safe, they're going to replace our meat. That's the good news. Bad news is it's blowing up rough, and it looks like it's going to be rough all weekend. So the ship can't get us our food at the moment to get out of it. So we'll have to play it by ear and hope they can get it. They might try and make a go for it later this afternoon, but I doubt it. And the rest of the weekend, the forecast is foul. So, perhaps Monday. So, we've all got to try and make what food we've got go as far as we can. In my case, I brought salad out for the first week, so looks like I've got egg salads until they arrive. The only downer is, for me breakfast, I have muesli and yoghurt. And I've got the muesli, they've got the yoghurt, so... oh well, play that one by ear as I come to it. After I have an apple or something for breakfast instead, I think. And that's about it. They've put me in charge for the weekend because Dave Hindmarsh didn't want to do it, so for the weekend, for the 2 weeks. So I've got that to do as well. Saucepan away so it won't get natural.
Well, the mermaid arrived about 7:30 this morning. This is the second day. There's a mermaid over there. And delivered all our frozen food and breakfast stuff. So we're okay now. That's north. Back towards the Needles Rocks, looking east. And St. Catherine's will be down that way.
Mermaid, this is Needles, test call, over. Thank you.
Well, Saturday's been and gone. As you saw on the film, we did oil and water today. The mermaid came in quite early, about 7:30 this morning. First of all, delivered our frozen food that had been left behind, and my breakfast, more importantly. So we now got all our grubs, they're okay. And then I got up about 9 o'clock-ish, and the mermaid worked the boys in the area, sort of repairing stuff. And then just about bang on dinner time, they decided to come and fuel and water us, just to top us up. So we were down there till about 4 to half past. They topped us up with water and fuel. So now that should be it for a fair while. Got stacks left. So now we're into Sunday. I've done me 12 o'clock to 8 o'clock, 8 p.m. Watch Saturday, and it's now my midnight till 4 in the morning watch. It's now just gone 1 o'clock in the morning, Sunday morning. So 3 more hours of watch, and then I can call out Laurie, and then it'll be bed for me. And probably see from me bags under my eyes, I feel like I need it at the moment. Just going to go in a minute, do me walk around the building, make sure light's going okay and the engines aren't overheating. Just have a look out in case there's any ops about.
going since I'm in the patch ready as well. I'm in their cell for when the sugar they redesign packaging.
And here's the toilet pipe that goes out and overflows outside. We've got a force 8 blowing outside, forcing waves back up the broken pipe. And that's seeping with you know what. And it's been spreading out all over the floor, everywhere. This room is just swimming in it now. It's absolutely disgusting. We've got food in the fridges behind me. We've got vegetables and apples and stuff, fruit over there. And directly below us is the bedroom, so we don't know how long this lot's going to take before it gets down there. All we've got to do is keep mopping it up and hope when the weather abates we can get out and stick some rods up this flipping pipe to get rid of it all. Now I've got three kids at home and I'm used to changing nappies, but this, can't stick much longer in here, I tell you. The other thing that's occurred to us, apart from having to start using a bucket instead of a loo that we haven't got anymore, we're supposed to have a mechanic coming out. It was coming today. Looks like now it'll be tomorrow. So what we're gonna do, four of us, sharing a bucket, I don't know. I know we were saying downstairs jokingly that we wanted to get our own back on Trinity House, so making us all redundant in the future. But this wasn't quite the way we thought of when we thought of getting our own back, I can tell you.
toasted about 8 this morning, and that was a lot then. Yeah, it was off of the crop pipe. Yeah.
What is it, the sun, Laurie?
Disgusted by threesomes. My girlfriend. What do I think of the sun?
Is that recording the shoulders, aren't they, is it?
Yes.
It's terrible when you get these swatters on station, isn't it?
Yeah. Suffice to say, I think of the sun the same as I think of the group of Lurie.
Surgery seems to be doing the job on the burn.
There's an inspection coming this week. I'll put you on the day by Marsh Rogers because he knows a lot more about it. He's been here for a couple of years and knows a lot more about it. It's Roger Day to say, John,
hello there. Yeah, we've been having this problem the other day. We had a strong wind. The toilet was blocked up. I mean, we're talking about 30 feet. That's where we've been building up. And with the wind, it bursted open, and when the teams went upstairs, the whole of the service room was just literally full of it. It took us nearly 6 to 7 hours to clear it all up. The other thing is, just going off a bit, where this, right next to the toilet, we've got two fridges. One? Well, no, just the two fridges there, but all this stuff's around, and we keep all our fresh veg up there as well. That's the only place we'll keep it. That was all contaminated, and Captain Kate's going to give us permission to get fresh veg out again. But I said that's the only place we'll store it.
Right.
But the toilet itself, where the toilet is, there's a 12-foot runoff alongside the wall before it goes out, and it's vertical. No, it's just straight. And there's a slight bend coming round which goes out the tower.
Medical
job, and I've got a kidney infection. And well, I've got it gone, but I was covered in crap. But No, we've got nothing like that. Oh, we've got nothing like that because we do our refluence them by local port, by tender, not by helicopter. Yeah.
How's that?
Yeah.
If you like, that's great, mate. Another one down.
Yeah.
when we took on, there's no keepers there. There was no one watching keepers at all for the night. And all was turned in. I literally heard people having a conversation. Two voices downstairs in the mess room. I walked down there thinking someone had left the television on. We've all been turned in. Not myself, George Gordon, Ben Ashley. We've all heard it.
Yeah.
And on one occasion, George and myself woke up and we thought it was Lenny. Onto the boat, and looked at his bunk, and he was there asleep, not totally asleep. I'm bugging if we go downstairs and find out, because I've sealed it. I never saw anything. I heard
wolf?
Conversations.
Or it serves on
the wolf.
Yeah, the wolf rock. And no wind, nothing.
So on the long storm there, Time T's television came out on the anniversary of Grace Darling. When I heard the footsteps of Grace Darling going down on the passageway. 6:30 in the morning, I went down normal procedure to the radio beacon. See the straight face. The beacon. Stella, I was with it. So, I was quite sober at the time.
You should have got in a tight fear.
I went down, I timed the beacon. Well, I timed the old fashioned type beacon in. When I timed it in, I heard these footsteps. I said, I thought somebody was prattling around us. I opened the door and said, what the hell are you playing at? All the keepers were in bed. I heard the footsteps go all the way down the passageway. And I saw the door open and shut. And I shot upstairs out the bloody road.
Yeah.
I thought somebody was mucking around with us.
Yeah,
but it was. I heard the footsteps, literally footsteps going down. And I'm not normally frightened, but when I opened the door and I saw the other door open and shut, I went up the vertical ladder out the road. It was taboo to go back in the back cottages, because so many keepers had a frightened experience in the back cottage. And I said, I spent 10 years there.
The thing
was built on the monastery. But the whole lighthouse was built on the monastery. You got to go actually in the crypt. You know, when you were there, did you go in the crypt? You actually go in the crypt of the monastery.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it's a funny feeling. There's not many keepers who go out the back way into the crypt.
This is also another one that's got to be replaced by the east left, as I say, on 12-11. Showing signs of rust on the weld. Central seam. Apart from that, it's not too bad. It's in condition. It's good for another 12 months. Going back to his house. Get the rest of the number two.
And that's fuel and water.
Fuel and water. Manifolds.
So blue pipe is for water. A red one for fuel.
Mm-hmm.
With different size couplings. Thank you.
right, another one. On the left.
Bring a fender in, Laurie. There's a fine fellow.